My name is Maribeth, and I'm a software engineer on the Blockley team. In this talk, I'll discuss some strategies you can use when debugging an application built on Blockley. When developing any application, at some point you'll hit a wall where you have a cryptic error message or things just aren't happening the way you expect. We have several tools that we use on the Blockley team to help figure out what's going on, and they can be used in your projects built on Blockley as well.
First, you should know about the Blockley Playground. The Playground is a pre-configured environment with Blockley that has several settings you can modify and debug tools built in. If you're trying to experiment with the different scroll wheel settings, or working on a custom renderer and want to see the bounds of each block, or maybe you want to compare generator output between your custom generator and the default ones, the Playground could help. There is one built into Blockley, or you can even incorporate one into your own project. I won't go into detail about it here, because Sam did a great talk at the 2021 summit about using the Playground and other developer tools. You can find it with previous summit videos on the Blockley developer site. Next, you should also know about source maps and how to use them. Blockley is published as compressed code. It's smaller and faster to load for users, but at the expense of being difficult to read for developers. If you are debugging your application and you see lines of code in Blockley with difficult to read variable and function names, that is going to be pretty challenging for you to understand and figure out which line is actually causing the error. Fortunately, there is a solution to that, and that is source maps. Source maps provide a way to show the browser there's a mapping between compressed code and uncompressed code. With source maps enabled, the browser can automatically tell you that the confusing line you're looking at actually corresponds to the line Blockley field text input do value update. Then you can read the source code or use the debugger while knowing the uncompressed line of code that's giving you problems. We bundle the source maps automatically with Blockley. They are in blockleycompressed.js.map and blockscompressed.js.map. How exactly you use them will depend on your exact development setup. If you're using Webpack, you can use the source map loader plugin. Using source maps will ensure you can actually see the human-readable code that you're interacting with, which should make it a lot easier to debug if you are currently trying to debug with compressed code. Once you have source maps set up, you are in good shape to just explore what's going on in your browser's console. You can use the browser's developer tools to set breakpoints, view errors, and inspect local variables. I'll also show you some tips that we use when debugging Blockley. The first one is blockley.version. This is really useful if you need to check the version. If you have just updated and you can't find a new method, check to see that you have the expected version. So in this case, I have version 8. That's exactly what I thought. Another useful tool is blockley.getmain workspace. This function gets the workspace so that you don't have to find it in the element browser. So now we have a workspace and we can explore other properties on the workspace. We can check the connection checker or the connection database, anything on the workspace that we want to get. We now have a handle to this workspace over here without having to go dig around in the element list in the console. There we also have blockley.selected, which does the same thing, but for the currently selected block. So right there, I forgot to select a block, but if I have one selected and I try again, now I have a block. And so now the same thing applies where I have a handle on this block so I can check, you know, if I need to debug and check its color or what kind of context menu options it has. Any properties on the block, now you have a handle to it so you can check it in the console. And now that you have that block, one other thing that you might want to do is check the input list. So let's say that let's save a reference to this block. So I have this block, blockley.selected, and now I can look at the input list. So I'm gonna look at block A.input list, and it has two inputs, and that's what I expect. One of them is this Boolean input right here that I have a block connected. I have this true block connected. And one of them is called do, and it's a statement input. So one's a value input, one's a statement input. And then if I was writing a custom block, I could check to make sure that my fields look the way I expected. So if you're creating custom fields or custom blocks, then exploring this way can be really useful to find out what's actually happening in the block that you're making. So this first input, the while true here, we can see it's fields, and one of them is a dropdown, which makes sense because we have this while dropdown here. And one of them is a label, and that's just the word repeat right here. So that all makes sense. Another thing you can do with the block that we've saved is check the connections. So we can check next and previous connections, but this block doesn't have any, and this also doesn't have any output connections. So let's select a different block and see what happens. So if we select this set answer to block, I'm going to call that something else. But now it's the selected block, so it's really easy to get a handle on it. And then I can check block B dot next connection. And here we have a connection because there is a block, in fact, connected to the next connection. And so now I can inspect that connection. So again, if you're creating custom blocks or you're trying to debug, maybe you've programmatically connected blocks together and something's not happening right with it, then you can check the connections this way. And then same for output connections. So these blocks with the puzzle pieces like this, that's an output connection. So if you need to check what that's connected to, that's another way to get it. And then, like we talked about before with the advanced playground, you can change any of the settings here. So another thing you can check with the advanced playground is the generator output. So if you're creating custom blocks and you're writing the generator for it, then you can check what that generator output would be in the different languages. And then using the developer tools, you can even add other generator languages here if you create your own generator. But this is a really easy way to test it because it actually refreshes automatically. So if I add another block here, then it'll actually update automatically. So that's a really easy way to test your generated output. Sometimes when you are developing a plugin, you might realize that you need changes in core Blockley to support your idea. Therefore, you need a way to locally test changes in Blockley and in a separate application at the same time. The way to do that is by using npm link. You can make changes to core Blockley and then build and package Blockley using our scripts. Then run npm link, which creates a symlink to the package that can be used in other projects. In your plugin, you can run npm link Blockley, which tells npm, instead of getting Blockley from the npm registry, it should use the locally linked version, which you just set up. Then you can run your plugin like usual, but it will use your local changes to Blockley. Doing that, you can make sure that the changes you made in core Blockley will work with your plugin. The same technique can also be used to link two plugins together or a plugin with local changes into your application. Finally, there may still be situations where you need some outside help. You probably already know of the Blockley forum, where our team provides developer support, but I want to share some tips that make it easier and faster for us to help you. You will probably get better answers the more specific you can be. If you ask, how do I customize the toolbox, then most likely someone will send you a link to the documentation or the code lab about this topic. If you've already read those and you're confused about a certain topic, then asking, how can I change the font of a label I added to the toolbox? Here's what I tried so far. And posting your code will likely get you a more specific answer that is more useful to you. Similarly, your question has to be actionable. If you say, my code isn't working and nothing else, then we have nothing to go on either. We need to know what you're trying to do and how you're trying to do it. So post your code and your error messages too. Also, it can help to tell us your motivations before diving right into the problem you're facing. It might be there is a better solution to your main problem, and we're debugging a solution that isn't a good fit for your original goal. Knowing what you're trying to accomplish can help us steer you in the right direction. That's all I have for you today. I hope these tips help you get unstuck next time you're facing a problem in Blockley.